Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, you were introduced to A2Beauty in Flame 2019. This powerful selective effects is designed for beauty retouching and much more. It can tackle small blemishes, spots and wrinkles, but it can also take bigger issues like deep lines and other obvious problems. In this video, you'll learn how to remove the bags from under a model's eyes through the deeper use of the A2Beauty toolset. We'll be using batch for this example, but as seen in the previous video, you can also do the same steps in the timeline using the effects tab and the image timeline effects. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, please type the displayed link in your favorite web browser. Now switching to batch, here is the downloaded media, and the batch duration is set to 25 frames, matching the source clip. Now you could use action if you were incorporating 3D compositing with this image. Or you could use the image node, which mainly focuses on general look development. It won't make a difference either way, but we'll use the image node to keep us more focused on the task. Locate and drag out the image node from the batch node bin. Connect the image into the red front input. Double-click the node for its controls and press F4 for the result view. Zoom into the image and scrub the time bar. Now there are other areas which you could retouch on her face, but the most prominent issue are the bags under her eyes. So let's apply A2Beauty and retouch those areas on her face. Hold space and click on Selective 1 in the Selective Manager. Pick the A2Beauty Selective Effects at the top of the list. The shader applies itself to the whole image, so next you'll constrain it with a mask. Call up the contextual menu over the Selective 1 and add a free mask. You can also do this by pressing Space G. Next, press F8 to switch to the mask's object view. This will not only allow you to see the image clearly, but you can also adjust the masks faster in this view. Starting with her right eye, start drawing the mask close to her eyelid, and then create an arch by her cheekbone. Once you've closed the shape, tweak it a bit more to get it looking like this. Now press F4 to return to the result view, and you can already see the A2Beauty doing its magic. To fix the edges, you'll need to create 3 gradient spline points. Using the contextual menu, place 2 under the eyelid and 1 at the bottom of the mask. Next, pull the top 2 just below the eyelid, and the bottom gradient point should come up quite high. This helps blend things together. Select Selective 1 and turn the icons off. Toggling the Selective with H, you can see the difference with just the default settings. If you go to the A2Beauty tab and switch to the viewing menu, you can enable the preview, which gives you a grayscale analysis, and this shows you exactly what the A2Beauty is detecting within the constraining mask. Disable the preview viewer. Looking at the current result, there are still a few color and blending issues in order to make this better. So switch to the A2Beauty controls menu and increase the fix size to around 35 to eliminate the darker areas under the eyes. Now it's going in the right direction, but the issue is that the fix is working by an equal amount in the horizontal and vertical directions. That works fine for flat skin, but if you're dealing with any kinds of lines or contours, you need to be able to control the ratio and angle of the fix. So adjusting the ratio reshapes the fix between the horizontal and vertical. And the angle slider allows you to realign the fixing results to any lines you are working on. So if the ratio is 0.4 and the angle is minus 21 degrees, you get a much more balanced color and lighting on the constraint mask. This gives you a more naturalistic look. Now the recover amount allows you to control how much detail, texture, and grain is restored. So if you're going for a really smooth look, you lower the value by a large amount. Zero just gives you a flat smudge. So it's a balance between fix and details. The size refers to the grain size in the recovery amount. And the search radius expands the region scanned by A2Beauty when looking to recover detail after the fix. You can adjust these to taste. The overdrive value allows you to crank up the whole A2Beauty amount above and beyond all the other sliders. So it could be useful in some cases, but this isn't one of them. Finally, the A2Beauty shader does flatten lighting as part of the retouching effect. But it is possible to bring back some of this information after applying the fix. The highlights takes care of the specular light, and the shadows adjusts the darker regions, including ambient occlusion. You don't tweak this too much, otherwise you'll bring back the lines in the affected region. So you have a lot of flexibility and control when it comes to A2Beauty. Now let's reuse this A2Beauty selective effects under the other eye. Turn the icons back on, either through the pull-down menu or toggle the eye keyboard shortcut. You could copy selective 1 to selective 2 and have separate controls for each area. This gives great flexibility, but doubling the shaders and selectives can impact performance compared to a single selective with multiple masks. You use whichever method suits the job. Let's add another mask to selective 1. Call up the contextual menu over selective 1 and add another free mask. As before, press F8 for the mask object view. Draw the mask along the eyelid and round off the shape using a control point on the cheekbone. You might want to tweak it after creating it. Press F4 for the result view and add the three gradient points around the spline as before. Pull the top two gradient points below the eyelid and drag up the third gradient point. Now select selective 1 again and turn the icons off. Toggling the H keyboard shortcut, you can see how you've cleaned up the areas under both eyes. Finally, we deal with moving images. Scrubbing the time bar, you can see that you lose the retouching effect as the model and camera move. So the masks need to be tracked to the image. Go back to the first frame. In the previous video, you tracked the masks using planar tracking, and you could still use the method successfully. In this example, you'll use motion vectors to track the masks to her face. Turn the icons on again and frame the image to the view. To create and apply the motion vectors to the masks, you'll need to use the schematic view. Press Alt-2 for a two-up view. Hover over one of the views and press the tilde shortcut to bring up the schematic. Select one of the mask objects in the flow graph. Go to the node bin and locate the motion vectors map. Drag it out and it will connect itself to the selected G mask. Since you'll want to track both masks with the motion vectors, connect the other G mask to the motion vectors map. Now you can work slowly as the motion vectors generate per frame. Or you can double-click on the motion vectors map and switch to the analysis menu. Click Cache Range. This might take a few minutes, but the motion vectors will be cached for faster performance. Now double-click the first GMOS node and switch to its tracking menu. Set the mode to Motion Warp and add a reference frame. Select the second GMOS node and switch the tracking mode to Motion Warp. Click Add Reference again. Finally, turn the icons off. If you scrub the time bar, you can see that the mask's result is tracking with the image, thus removing the bags from under the model's eyes. If you switch back to a single view with Alt-1 and toggle between the front source and the result, you can see what a difference A2Beauty has made to the image. So hopefully, you'll find A2Beauty useful in your everyday work. However, one thing to bear in mind is that there are many other applications for A2Beauty aside from beauty work. Sure, you can clean up skin, but it can also be used on other textures to clean and remove imperfections. We'll cover a few more of those use case scenarios in future videos. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.